Hi everyone, it's Gus from Palmer Life, and today I'll be going through how to set up a Samba server on the Raspberry Pi. First, open the terminal on the Raspberry Pi, or SSH to it. Now in the terminal, enter sudo apt update to update our package list. And now run sudo apt upgrade to upgrade all our packages. Now run the following command to install all the packages required for Samba. Sudo apt install samba-common-bin. Now enter y and then enter. Now we want to set up a directory for our network share. This directory can be located anywhere, including on a mounted external hard drive. But for this tutorial, we will be making it in the home directory. To do this, write mkdir /shared. To confirm this directory was created correctly, enter ls. You should see the shared directory in the directory list. It's now time to set up our Samba config to use our newly created directory. To do this, enter sudo /etc/samba/smb.conf. In this file, scroll down to the bottom. Now enter /pymylifeup/share². This block defines the start of a new Samba share. The text between the square brackets is the name that will be assigned to your share. Feel free to update this to a different name. Now enter path equals then the path to the directory that you wish Samba to share. In my case, it's /home/pi/shared. If you're using a different user to Pi, you'll need to update Pi to the username that you are using. Now enter writable equals yes. This will allow the folder to be writable. If you write no, it will block any user from being able to write to the share, making it read only. Now enter browsable equals yes. Setting this option to yes will allow other users to find this share on your network. If you set it to no, you'll be required to enter the share path to be able to connect to it. Lastly, enter public equals no. If public is set to no, a valid user will be required to access the Samba share. Now that we're done, you can exit and save by pressing Ctrl+X, then Y, followed by Enter. Now we need to set up a Samba password for our user. To do this, enter sudo smb-passwd-a, then your username. In my case, it's Pi. Now you will need to enter your SMB password. This is separate to your normal login. Then you'll need to enter it again. If it was successfully added, you should see added, user, then your username. In my case, it's Pi. This is the username and password you'll need to use to connect to your shares. Now we need to restart the Samba service so that it loads in our new configuration. To do this, enter sudo systemctl restart smbd. You may need the Raspberry Pi's hostname or IP address. To get the hostname, simply enter hostname. To get the IP address, enter hostname-I. And the IP address is the first one in the list. Now we're ready to connect to the share from a different computer. In this example, I am using Windows. Within File Explorer, click This PC. In the taskbar, click on the three dots and then click Map Network Drive. In the folder text box, enter // the hostname of your Raspberry Pi /PyMyLifeUpShare. If hostname doesn't work, you can swap it out for the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. Now click Finish. You will now need to enter the SMB username and password. In my case, the username is Pi and the password is the same as the one we set earlier. Now let's test the network share by creating a folder, then creating a file, editing the file, then lastly saving the file. If you didn't get any errors, everything is working correctly. You can double check by going back to your Raspberry Pi. I hope this video has helped you create a Samba server on your Raspberry Pi. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.